Hello everyone, welcome to the official YouTube channel of ISBR Business School. We have Professor Satya Kiran amongst us. Professor Satya Kiran is a recruitment professional with more than 17 years of experience in training, design and delivery. He was one of the four professors in Andhra Pradesh to be selected by IBM to host the Great Mind Challenge. Also, he's teamed with IAS, Principal Secretary, Information Technology, Government of Karnataka, to organize an India Infrastructure Seminar Series in IIT Madras. He was selected by the US State Department and Niti Aayog to be part of the super prestigious Global Entrepreneurship Summit held in 2017, which was inaugurated by Prime Minister Narendra Modi and the Special Advisor to the President of the United States. He moderated a panel discussion featuring Shashi Tharoor recently on creating future-ready education. He was also a master of ceremony for an entrepreneurship dialogue featuring former PepsiCo and Apple CEO. He's also a TEDx speaker. So ladies and gentlemen, we have an amazing, multi-talented, intelligent and the most prestigious guest of our institution. I welcome you, sir. It's a privilege to have you amongst us.
Thank you very much, Shruti. The introduction is all fine, but the prestigiousness of my profile is something that I don't accept. Anyway, that's thank you. It's a very humbling experience to be part of this very short talk, and I'm hopeful that at the end of this. This talk, I would have given you a lot of knowledge about an important issue, which is careers and the future of careers in India.
Exactly.
So please.
So Professor Satya will be talking about the evolution of careers and the impact of several factors on the future of the careers in India. So my very first question to you will be, since all of us are working hard every single day to build our respective careers, so what can be the expected career opportunities in India?
Great question, Shruti. See, the past 1.5 years have been extremely tough. If anyone had told you on December 31st, 2019, that an invisible enemy would end up house arresting 90% of humanity, you would be laughing it off as a joke. But what is normally considered to be a joke became a coronavirus pandemic, right? So the news about India, the news surrounding India in the past 1.5 years had been very grim and pessimistic. There is a lot of truth in this pessimism also. India's economy fell by 23-24% in the third quarter of last year. Mm-hmm. There was record unemployment. Many industries, especially in the medium, micro and small enterprise space, many of them had to shut door because of the dip in aggregate demand, right? So this pessimism about India, this pessimism about the future of India at this point of time seems justified. Let's be very clear about it. But having said that, if you look into the future, then let's say 5 years or 6 years down the line, this particular pandemic would be a thing of the past, right?
Exactly.
And we have to understand that India is going to be a world-beating nation in the next half a decade to a decade. Why do I say that? The answer is very simple. Number one, we have a very big mass of very well educated, skilled and competent youngsters, right? India has a major advantage in the form of what I call, or what we call, demographic dividend, which means we have a young and mobile population, which mm-hmm. is going to drive the next wave of growth. I'll give you a figure. 65% of India's population is under the age of 35. That is 74 crore Indians are under the age of 35. And this is a very important population segment because it is this young, educated, skilled and competent workforce that is going to drive India's growth. You agree?
Yes, right? Yes.
So on the one hand, we have a young population in India. On the other hand, the advantage that India has in the global economy is, while India has a young population, the rest of the world, including the US, Russia, China, and Japan, have aging populations, right? So yes, that is why these countries actually want well-educated Indians to come and develop their economy. So this is a massive opportunity for us. Let's not forget that. Very, very massive opportunity. Number two, thanks to globalization and thanks especially to the internet, the world has become a flat place today, right? I'm saying this metaphorically, obviously not physically. The world is oval shaped, but metaphorically speaking, we are living in a flat world, which means the aspirations that a young American has are the same kind of aspirations that Indians also have, right?
Exactly. Yes, right? Sir.
We want to have the best of clothes. We want to travel in the best of automobiles, best of experiences. So the youngsters of today will create massive internal demand for goods and services. Right?
True, sir.
I'm saying we have a twofold advantage. One, the entire world's population is growing and they want youngsters and educated folks from India to come and develop their economy. So Indians will succeed. Secondly, India itself is going to have a massive uptick in demand over the next 2-3 decades. And so companies that cater and companies that can cater to this increased demand from youngsters will be able to build great businesses in India. The third factor is, this is very important. The third factor is, as I said, 74 crore Indians are under the age of 35. The government realizes that if we do not educate these youngsters, if we do not give them the skill sets that they require to create a career, a future career, then this demographic dividend I talked to you about,
yes,
will turn into demographic disaster, right? So what the government has realized is, it has realized that for the next wave of growth to kick in, they have to create a policy that will help create small and medium enterprises. And that is why the startup policy that was created by the government is enabling this next wave of growth. I'll give you one example, very simple example. Zomato was created less than 10 years back. Today, it had a massively successful IPO recently.
Exactly. It has been listed down in the stock markets. That's one of the biggest things.
Very, very correct. BSE and NSE. But we have had an even bigger success story 4 days back. You know what it is?
No idea, sir.
Freshworks, which is an Indian IT company started by a middle class guy called Girish Mathrubhutam, was listed on the NASDAQ and it is valued at $14 billion. $14 billion. So my point to all youngsters, if you're listening to me, is there is no dearth of opportunities in India. There is no dearth of opportunities in India. If you skill yourself, if you develop the competency and the hunger, very important. You need that fire in the belly. That hunger is very required, right? If you have the passion, hunger, vision, and a sense of mission, India is the sunrise country of the world. So that answers your first question.
Yes, sir. Definitely. I agree. I completely agree. And it's like something, we are competing with all the other countries. We are no less than any other country in this world. India has become a powerful nation and it will keep on growing. We are not limited to any opportunities and we can have access to anything. We do have access to each and everything in this world. And every single individual sitting in any corner of the world, that person has an access to everything. Indians also have access to each and everything in this world.
Exactly. And Shruti, you have one more advantage, which is the fact that you are in Bangalore.
Exactly, sir.
Bangalore is well and truly the technological epicenter of the world, right?
Yes.
We call it the Silicon Valley of India. I disagree. We are not the Silicon Valley of India. We are the Silicon Valley of Asia. I don't think there is any other technology cluster in Asia which produces as much IT activity as Bangalore does. I'll give you one more fact which supports Bangalore and its status as the tech capital of Asia. There are about 65 unicorns in India. Any idea what a unicorn is? So basically there are 65 unicorns in India. A unicorn is a billion dollar plus valuation company is called a unicorn, right? So there are about 65 unicorns in India, out of which 39 unicorns either have a presence in Bangalore or either they have a presence in Bangalore or they were created in Bangalore.
That's such a big number,
sir.
That's
what I'm saying. That's a big number. Just one city has a preponderant dominance on the startup and technological landscape in India.
Yes, yes.
And if you believe technology is the future, you have to believe that Bangalore is the future of India.
Definitely. Definitely, right, sir. So my next question will be, what are the factors that impact the nature and structure of careers in the future in India?
Well, I would extend the question and say the nature and structure of careers, not just in India, but across the world, because technology knows no country, it knows no boundaries, right? So what will impact the structure and nature of careers in India? I'll give you my own example. I mean, my own family example. My father was a civil servant. He joined the government of India at the age of 23. He retired at 60. Mm-hmm. He was in one company for 37 years, and that company is the government of India, right? To put it in a slightly jocular way. So he was in the government of India for 37 years. And he used to tell me that, Kiran, the challenges that you have, that your generation has, are very different from our generation, because he said that he worked in a cradle to grave job. So, wo unka shuruaat bhi government of India mein hua tha, aur unka retirement mein bhi government of India mein hua tha, right? So, cradle to grave. He had one job. I shifted about 4 jobs in the past 17 years. And your generation may shift a job every year, right? And what is bringing about this shift? This is what the question is all about. I think the most important factor that is bringing about a radical shift in the nature and structure of careers is technology. I don't think there's any other factor.
Yes, sir.
I'll give you one theory that a very famous writer named Thomas Friedman, right? There's a famous writer and journalist called Thomas Friedman who writes for the New York Times. He says, all of us are living in a internet technopoly. So I'll explain what it is. He says, all of us, everyone in this world, 7.3 billion people living in this world, are living in this internet technopoly. He says, internet technopoly is, he says, we are living in the kingdom of technology, and we are ruled by an emperor called the internet. Right, you got it? So all of us are, in a way, living in this kit or one area of our life that is not impacted by technology today. There is no area that I can think of which is not impacted by technology. You go to a vegetable seller today, even a vegetable seller gives you the option of paying by phone pay or GPay
yes.
or Paytm.
Even a cobbler.
Absolutely, absolutely. So see how technology has transformed. And and at the apex of this technology is the internet, right? You agree? All of us agree.
Right.
So what are those factors that are going to impact careers in the future? Are very simple. Number one, the internet. Number two, automation. It's a very major danger.
Mm-hmm.
Automation. Jobs are being automated. In fact, in software, 15 years back, India was called the BPO capital of the world. But where are BPOs today? They have been eaten away by technology automation.
Yes.
Right. So number one, I would say, is the internet. Internet is a dominant factor of change in career structure. Number two, artificial intelligence. Number three, automation. Mm-hmm. Big data and analytics. Robotic process automation. Right. Internet of things. Social media. Cloud computing. I think these are some of the factors that are going to change the nature of careers, not just in the future. They're actually changing it right now.
The impact has started technology is the future of India.
It is the present and the future, certainly. And technology will play an increasingly important role. It will play an increasingly important role in shaping our lives and our careers going forward. I was going through this, I was going through Udemy. I don't know how many of you are aware of Udemy and Coursera. Mm-hmm. There is a program, there is a course on Udemy called how to maximize your social influencer role. This was unthinkable for us, that you can make tons of money as a social media influencer. My generation doesn't even understand social media well. Forget about creating a profile, a great profile on social media, and creating and becoming an influencer. For us, an influencer was a politician, was an influencer, or a civil servant was, or a film star was. But today, everybody is a film star on social media.
So, looking at the smallest example, a smartphone was developed with an idea to connect people. Now, a lot of people are earning their entire expenses. They're covering their entire expenses. They are going on trips, vacations, or just with a smartphone. They are like running their lives with a smartphone, with a small device.
Absolutely.
We had no idea about it.
Absolutely. So that is why my mantra, Shruti, for all the youngsters is, please learn every day. Okay. Please unlearn every day, and please relearn every day. Learning never stops. Real learning actually begins after you get educated. Then you realize that every day is a battle, and to succeed, you've got to learn and expand the frontiers of your knowledge and awareness.
Keep upgrading yourself.
Every day, every single day, you have to be a better version of yourself than what you were yesterday. This is the only way to succeed. There is no other. There is no other mantra. There is no other secret. So the secret is keep learning, and this is a message that I'll say a million times, right? If you want to stay ahead of the race, you've got to develop the stamina to learn, unlearn and relearn.
Absolutely, sir. Completely agreed what you said, and I've got to learn a lot, many new things. So I'm gonna decide my career based on this technological and everything. So I made my decision asking you on all the things.
And Shruti, there are still some areas where technology will not fully dominate, and that is the area that is creative areas, creativity, right? I don't think a robot can be invented that can write a beautiful essay. I don't think a robot can be invented, maybe I don't know, the creative industry is by and large, better guarded than the other industries from technology. That's why I encourage students to read. Please read. Set aside 2 hours every day. I mean, 24 hours minus 8 hours of sleep and some time attrition, right? So 8 hours is what you lose in terms of sleep and other activities. 16 hours, can't you spare 1 hour in the morning and 1 hour in the evening before you retire to bed to read? And reading is what will make you a superstar and a super performer in the long run. Aaj agar aap ek ghanta use karoge reading ke liye, aapko zyada difference pata nahi hoga. But 1 year down the line, when you look back on this particular year that you spent reading, you'll realize you've had massive improvement. I call this the 1% advantage. The 1% advantage. Every day, look at your life and say, I want to improve this 1% of my life. Just 1%, not difficult, right?
365% a year.
More than that, far more, compounded, right?
Yes, sir.
Today 100, tomorrow is 101. But the day after, it's 101 pe 1%. Na? See, that is the power of the compounded benefit. So, kuch nahi hai, mantra ek hi hai. Achha padho. Sat sang create karo. Be in the company of good people. Be in the company of people who add value to your life. Exactly. Not in the company of people who take value away from your life.
Also, sir, you'll get an opportunity and a job once in a lifetime or maybe once in a while, but to survive in that job, to survive in that profile and to make an impact on your job and whatever you're doing, consistency is very important and you have to grow each and every day.
Fully agree. Yes. Now you spoke like a professor.
No, sir, I've been talking to a lot of professors lately, so I'm trying to catch up things. Okay, sir. So we had a lot of knowledge, a lot of inspiration from you. So we'll share this video on the official YouTube channel of the ISBR Business School. And I am pretty sure that a lot of people will learn a lot, many things, and they will shape their careers, choose their careers and start learning, relearning, unlearning every day. They'll upgrade themselves. Thank you so much for taking out your time on a weekend. I'm so sorry to disturb you on weekend, but
not a problem. My pleasure, Shruti. I would like to end, with your permission, with a quote.
Sure.
I studied in the UK, so my university had this tagline or a philosophy called "Rerum cognoscere causas," which means try and understand the cause and the reasons for the existence of things. Why does this thing exist? What is the reason for this existence? And I would extend this question and say, ask yourself every day, what is the reason for my existence? When you ask that question, you get the purpose of your life. And when you get the purpose of your life, your progress and your success is guaranteed.
I will take some time to absorb this statement. It is amazing, sir. Amazing.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And thanks for this opportunity to interact with you and through you with the students. I wish them all the best. I want them to realize their potential and try to be the best of whatever they can be. So the competition is with themselves, not with the rest of the world. And I also want the students to know that we are not in a rat race. We should not be in a rat race, because even if you win in a rat race, you shall still remain a rat. You're not a rat, you're a human, and you deserve to succeed at your own pace and at your own will. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. That was an inspirational talk and we got to learn a lot, many things. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure to have you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.